We will see the different properties of aquifer. First important properties of the aquifer formation is hydraulic conductivity, which is denoted by letter K. The hydraulic conductivity is defined as the rate of flow of water in liter per day through a horizontal cross sectional area of 1 square meter of the aquifer under a hydraulic gradient of 1 meter per meter length at a prevailing temperature of water. The second important properties of aquifer is the transmissibility. Transmissibility is defined as the rate at which water will flow through a vertical strip of the aquifer 1 meter wide and extending through the full saturated thickness of the aquifer under a unit hydraulic gradient. This unit hydraulic gradient is important here. The transmissibility may be defined as a product of K and B, where K is the hydraulic conductivity and B is the thickness of the aquifer. It represents the water transmitting capability of the entire thickness of the confined and semi-confined aquifers. The transmissibility is the product of K into B is used to calculate how much water will move through the water-bearing formation or aquifer. The flow denoted by letter small q through each meter width of the aquifer is represented by formula q is equal to k into b into I. Here k is the hydraulic average hydraulic conductivity of the material from top to bottom layer of the aquifer. The unit is meter per day. Small b is the thickness of the aquifer in terms of meter. I is the unit hydraulic gradient. I is the hydraulic gradient in case of transmissibility, it is considered as 1. The flow Q through a vertical section of the aquifer may be expressed as Q is equal to capital T into I into W. Here capital T is the product of hydraulic conductivity and thickness of the aquifer, that is KB. So Q is equal to KB into I into W. Here the I is taken as unit, that is 1. W is the width of the vertical section through which the flow of water occurs. The next important property of the aquifer is coefficient of storage or storage coefficient denoted by letter S. It is a property of confined and semi-confined aquifers only. It is defined as the volume of water the aquifer releases from or takes into storage per unit surface area of the aquifer per unit change in the component of the head normal to the surface. In a confined aquifer, the coefficient of storage is a result of compression of the aquifer and expansion of the contained water as a result of reduced pressure due to pumping. The value of storage coefficient is a dimensionless quantity. It may be ranges from 0.00001 to 0.001 for confined aquifers. The next important property is the specific yield. The specific yield is a property of unconfined aquifer only. It is defined as volume of water released or stored per unit surface area of the aquifer per unit change in the component of head normal to that surface. Under unconfined aquifer conditions, groundwater is derived from storage by gravity drainage of the voids in the portion of the aquifer that has been unwatered by pumping. When water is drained from an aquifer by gravity, only part of the total volume stored in its pores is released. The quantity of water that unit volume of the aquifer will yield when drained by gravity is called as specific yield. The part of the water that is retained in the aquifer mass is held against the force of gravity by molecular attraction and capillarity. The quantity of water that a unit volume of aquifer retains when subjected to gravity drainage is called as specific retention. Both specific yield and specific retention are expressed as a fraction of percentage. The sum of specific yield and specific retention equals to the porosity of the aquifer. This sentence is most important here. The addition of specific yield and specific retention must be equal to the porosity of the aquifer. In this figure, at the left side and at the right side, at the left side, the coefficient of storage is shown. At the right side, the specific yield is shown. At the right side, you can see the Unconfined aquifer is there because the bottom layer is impermeable layer, but the top layer of the aquifer is permeable, and that is the water table surface, and the pressure at the water table surface or at the water table is equal to the atmospheric pressure, and the unit decline of water table is shown there. Whatever quantity of water that is yielded or released due to the gravity force is called as specific yield in terms of unconfined aquifer. In the case of confined aquifer, you can see here the water bearing formation of the aquifer material is bounded in between two impermeable layers. One layer is at top and another one is at the bottom, and whatever the aquifer material is inside is in the inside in between these two impermeable layers. The aquifer is called as confined aquifer, and at the top you can see the unit decline of piezometric surface and unit cross sectional area. To decline the piezometric head up to unity from a unit cross sectional area, how much amount of water is being released from such aquifer is called as the coefficient of storage. Coefficient of storage, this term is used in case of confined and semi confined aquifer only, and specific yield is the term is used in case of unconfined aquifer only. It should be. The next important property is the hydraulic resistance, denoted by letter C. The hydraulic resistance, also called as a reciprocal leakage factor or resistance against vertical flow, is a property of a semi-pervious layer of the semi-confined aquifer. So hydraulic resistance is the property of only semi-confined aquifer. It is the ratio of B dash upon K dash, in which B dash is the saturated thickness of the semi-pervious layer only, and K dash is the hydraulic conductivity of for the vertical flow. It characterizes the resistance of the semi-pervious layer to upward or downward leakage. It is designated by the symbol C and has reduced dimensions of time. When the value of hydraulic resistance equals infinity, it indicates the layer is impervious. When the value of hydraulic resistance of any lithological section is equal to zero or nearer to zero, then it indicate as an aquifer. The hydraulic resistance can be represented by formula C is equal to B square upon KV, in which C is the hydraulic resistance in days, B is the leakage factor, K is the hydraulic conductivity of the aquifer, B is the thickness of the horizontal pervious stratum confined between horizontal semi-pervious and impervious layers. The last property of the aquifer is the leakage factor. Leakage factor is the property of course, semi-confined aquifer only. It is represented by formula B is equal to root of KB into C. Here K is the hydraulic conductivity, B is the thickness of the aquifer, and C is the hydraulic resistance, and B is the leakage factor. The leakage factor determines the distribution of leakage into or from the semi-pervious layer. High value of leakage factor indicate a great resistance of the semi-pervious strata to flow as compared to the resistance of the aquifer itself. It has this factor has dimensions of length. The value of leakage factor can be determined by pumping test data. This semi-confined aquifer.